Hey guys, it's Kim here. Welcome back to my channel. I'm here with Stella and we are in Gunma.
Yes!
So we are going to be spending 3 days in Gunma on a girls trip. I'm going to show you guys what we get up to. We're going to be doing activities that aren't too touristy, so let's go and have fun! First off is Harunohi Strawberry Farm. We are going to eat strawberries for 30 minutes. It was 2,100 yen, so I'm gonna eat as many strawberries as I can. Mm. Wow, that is juicy. I just realized it says juicy up there. This one's Kanahime, so they look a lot smaller. How about this one? Mmm! Oh! That's different. It's more sour than the other one. This is the best breakfast ever.
Mmm! Tastes different again.
Oh!
I think the ones that are white inside are sweeter.
Not sure what this one is, but juicy. I'm getting good at this.
Huge strawberry, look at that.
Located next to Maebashi Park, Rinkokaku is a complex of three wooden buildings that served as a state guest house for VIPs. Entrance is free to visit this historical building. It's very peaceful and you're able to walk around freely to relax and take photos. The corridors overlook a beautiful Japanese garden which you can also walk in and enjoy.
It's lunchtime and pork is famous in Gunma, so we're gonna eat tonkatsu.
Mm. So happy I can come to Gunma with you.
The bun is not oily.
Yeah.
So usually with tonkatsu I feel sick after eating because it's too oily, but this is, I don't know how they did it, but it's
not like
oily
very light.
Yeah.
And crunchy.
But it looks very thick.
After lunch, we went on a short walk to Arts Maebashi. Now, this is an art museum that originally used to be a shopping mall. I found this artwork really interesting. It's Tokyo, but it's a combination of photographs just combined together. After a long day of exploring Maebashi, we decided to go get a coffee and just enjoy a short break. Finally, to finish off day one, our last stop is Gyokyoshi for dinner. This restaurant specializes in Joshi Wagyu beef, which is served as sukiyaki or shabu shabu hot pots. The ingredients are all from Gunma and are of excellent quality. The staff cooked for you. The Wagyu beef had very thick marbling and just melted in your mouth. All of the ingredients worked so well together and the flavors were all delicious. For sukiyaki, you get a raw egg, mix the egg white and yolk together, and then dip the ingredients from the hot pot into the egg. It's just so good.
We made it to our hotel and we can relax for the night. That was a fun first day. We did a lot actually. Ate so much food. I'm so full. So we're just going to relax tonight, sleep. And then we've got another big day tomorrow in Gunma. It's our first time traveling together.
In five years.
So this is so nice. Yeah. A little girls' trip.
So I'm just going to do a quick room tour for you guys. Over here we have the closet where you can hang up your clothes. And then when you go down, there's an iron. On the other side, we have a microwave, and then a safe, a fridge, then over here just the table. Then there's a massage chair. I've never seen one in a hotel room before, but the bed is there. Then we've got the bathroom, which is a typical Japanese bathroom. It's day two, so I headed to the lobby into the restaurant to grab some breakfast. They had a huge variety of different dishes from Japanese to Western. I usually go for Western breakfast, and Stella here went for Japanese.
It's really interesting how fabric's made, because I buy fabric all the time to make dog bows for my business. Oh my god. I'm so bad. So we are going to be doing indigo dyeing, and we chose big handkerchiefs for our doggies.
Yes, I'm going to make it for my Komi-chan.
Yeah, this is for Hina-chan. We're gonna battle to see which one looks better. This is something nice you can take home to remember this trip. This is like from the anime. It's Nezuko. It kind of reminds me of like a rice, like you know the rice rolls when you go to dim sum.
That's good.
Oh wow, this is so soft. We are walking on the streets of Gunma. We are at Moriyaki Ryokan, so I'm going to give you guys a quick room tour. So this big room here, this is where Stella and I are going to be sleeping. They will move the table and then they will set up the futon later when we have dinner. Over here we have a lovely spot where we can sit down and enjoy the view. Unfortunately it's dark now, so you won't be able to see anything. We've got yukata that we can wear around this area, and we can wear this to dinner as well, so that's what we're gonna do after the change. Over here we've got a TV, and then there's a tea set in here, so we can have some hot tea which we can enjoy later tonight. And then let's go to the bathroom. We've got the sink, the showers in here, so it's just kind of like a typical Japanese business hotel. And then we've got the toilet, which is just in here. So we'll be taking a shower here tonight, but tomorrow morning we're gonna go to the onsen, which I'm super excited for. Apparently there is an outdoor onsen and there's a nice view as well. So we're gonna relax for a bit before dinner, and yeah, we'll see you guys after.
Oh my gosh, that just melts in your mouth, like it was was so soft. You didn't even have to chew it that much. It just dissolved. It was beautiful. And the ponzu sauce was really good too.
I usually eat bread for breakfast, but they didn't have toast, so I decided to get some rice.
Finally, you got rice.
Finally. Onsen tamago. So I'm just gonna pour it in here.
Wow, that looks so good. I usually eat natto for breakfast in Japan.
So healthy.
So healthy. And it becomes like this.
Wow. We are at Ishidangai, which is kind of like a shopping street that has a lot of souvenirs and they've got lots of street food. So it's called Ishidangai because Ishi is stone, Dan is stairs, and Gai is like a shopping street. We are going to go all the way up. There's a shrine right at the top as well. Hey Stella,
yeah?
Are we going to do competition?
Let's do battle again.
Battle again.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
I like it.
Kim got three and I only got one.
I somehow shot three. Our prize is a Umai ball. Stella, you can have one.
Thank you, you were so nice even though I lost.
We are in line to get some manju that's really famous here. It's called Chogetsudo. So we got some manju. Now the image of this is meant to be like onsen. So just earlier we were in the onsen and it was kind of like a brown color. That's the image this manju is supposed to give off. So we're gonna give this a shot. We waited in line for this. All right, cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm. Wow, this is like a puff.
Mmm.
It's soft and puffy. This is so interesting. I've never had manju like this before.
And inside, like, there are a lot of angko,
which is red bean. I usually have age manju, which is fried manju. But this is like boiled manju, I would say. No, steamed.
Steamed.
Going to do omikuji, which is finding out what my luck is, kind of like fortune telling. So it's 100 yen, put in the slot. Oh, okay. What is it? Please be good. Oh, daikichi! My fortune was daikichi, which is very good luck. Now, because it's very good luck, I'm not going to tie it here. You just take it home with you and keep your luck with you. You only tie it up if you have bad luck to, you know, make the bad luck go away. But I'm gonna keep this with me. Vegetable tempura. So we are inside Usaporo Kokeshi and we are going to be making our own Kokeshi doll today. So this is my first time doing this, so kind of nervous because I am not very good at drawing or painting. So we are going to do Kokeshi and we could actually choose between a number of different styles. I got this one because I realized I can use this maybe as like a pen holder or something. I'm gonna make a Shiba Inu. This is where I lose.
Wow, she's wearing kimono. Look, so good. And then look at this.
So we are at our final spot for this trip. We are at Imai Daruma Ten Naya, and we are going to be making our own daruma. So this is my first time doing it.
This is your first time?
This is my first time
too. Okay, so it's going to be fun. So a daruma is like a good luck charm in Japan. And what you do is you make a wish. When you make a wish, you draw on one of the eyes. So as you can see behind me, there's like a lot of daruma, right? But they don't have eyes. So when you make your wish, you draw an eye on the right eye, and then once your wish comes true, that's when you draw the second eye. So we are going to be decorating our own daruma. Maybe we can have another battle. Ooh. Yes, okay, let's go.
I'm going to win.
So we are all ready to make our daruma. Are you ready?
No, I'm a bit nervous. Oni-san will be the judge.
So you have to win for it to be a draw, you know.
Oh, that's true. She won twice. I won only once. Yeah. I have to win to make it draw.
How do we? Oh, this is instructions on how to do it, and I drew all over it. Great. I'm off to a very good start.
Okay, finished.
Wow! We finished our daruma. We drew the face and then we got our names written on them. So because we were having a battle, we're gonna see who's the winner.
Skila. Beautiful hour. Kimu, pretty hour.
Oh.
Okay?
Oh. He doesn't want to pick a winner.
Dude, it's an art. It's an art.
It's not meant to have a winner. So it's a draw.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a draw.
Yours is a beautiful, mine's a pretty hour.
Beautiful is better than pretty.
Excuse me. So we have to make a wish.
Ooh.
So we're going to draw on the eye. So
wow.
Are we going to make a wish today?
Yes.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay, let's do it. Have finished with our daruma. We can take it back home. That was really fun. I really enjoyed it. We made our wish, so hopefully they come true. So we are at the end of our trip.
Oh no, it's been so fun with you.
Yeah. So we're gonna head back to Tokyo. It's actually only 1 hour away. So time to go home.